Halston.
Galanos.
It's an estate of a former Halston Dior model, is that true?
Yeah.
I can't remember the last time I actually got so excited about an estate that I literally booked a ticket and hightailed it out. We are going to Chicago. What is it?
Holy Dinamontes.
Oh my god.
You have like Invisigirdle. That's why everything looks good on you.
This is the epitome of a wiggle dress. I can only do the little.
Right.
No, I say you're the best for last.
Oh my god. I can't believe it. I'm actually holding Michael Jackson's glove.
Isn't that beautiful?
Wow.
Get in there.
This vintage clothing store is a window into fashion's Hall of Fame. The way we were. This is it. Three easy payments, and this baby is all mine. I have one of the best jobs in the world. Other people invest in the stock market, and I invest in the Frock market. I'm really surprised that you're able to let go of these and grateful, because I love your collection.
Doris shops on her way up Machu Picchu. She shops on a ship in the Antarctic.
Yeah?
Absolutely.
What do we want?
Oh, hells yeah. Okay. She will do whatever she needs to do to find what she needs to wherever she's at.
What I look for is if it's iconic.
And this?
Nice. I think I'm going to say yes because we don't have anything like it. Mm-hmm. There's a lot more than just buying and selling. I mean, you need to really invest time in knowing the market. The maxi military?
Yeah.
And the turbaness?
Yes.
Okay. So if you know your fashion history and you see what was photographed over and over and over again, those are the things that will be really sought after in the future. So Tom Ford for Gucci, Alexander McQueen before he passed away. If you don't do your homework, you'll make a lot of expensive mistakes.
The way we wore.
Are you looking to sell? We get calls all the time of people wanting to sell their pieces.
If you just send us images.
We never know who's going to walk in the door, and we never know what's going to walk in the door.
Oh, thank you. Hey, Keith.
Hey, Doris, how are you?
Good.
Bought a few pieces for you to look at.
Excited to see what you brought. Keith Holman contacted me about a year ago for the first time, and I love quirky, eccentric characters, and he is always surprising me with the things that he has in his collection. How did you come across these pieces?
These are from my business partner, the late Warren Caton, A1 Pleating and Belting.
Wow.
He did the belting and pleating for Cher and for Michael Jackson. Pretty much all the belts from the Bad Tour and stuff like that.
Wow.
So I just kept everything once we sold the store. And this box had never opened them up. It's been 3 years.
Every time he calls me, he has my attention. Oh, it's amazing. Yards of fabric.
Yeah.
It's beautiful.
Yeah. I knew you would get a kick out of this one.
It's really beautiful.
Now this, you know, there's one of these. It's not quite as extravagant as this one, but it's in the Smithsonian also.
Wow. Summer of 1925.
Yeah.
This daytime couture coat is a lightweight wool and could only have been owned by a woman of substantial means. Made in France, this is very reminiscent of Indian or Persian influence. And all of this embroidery
is... Oh, this is magnificent, yeah.
It's all with metallic threads. It's beautiful. Fashion is art on many levels. So when I find the artistic pieces, that really rings my bell. Do you like this?
I do. Yeah, I'm
kind of... Adrian.
If you love the movies, you love Adrian.
Adrian was one of the greatest costume designers of all time. He did The Wizard of Oz, Jean Harlow, Greta Garbo, I mean...
Joan Crawford.
Wow. And then at some point in the 40s, he started to create his own clothing that he sold in stores.
Yes. And this is 48, 49, Spanish collection. I thought it was couture, but it's ready to wear.
Mm-hmm.
So it's model number 8217.
I could see that on the red carpet now, on some young ingenue. Like, it's so perfect.
With alabaster skin.
Yeah.
Miley Cyrus.
If only they would wear anything that covered their bodies.
Now I save the best for last. Here you go.
Oh, boy, I like what I see already.
Oh, my God.
This is Parisian, and it is absolutely amazing.
Oh.
Yeah, this is like the crown. This is for an actress, but I don't know what actress it was for.
Wow.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Talk about a true flapper dress.
Mm-hmm. Look at this
Sarah,
one.
That's a stunner.
Mm-hmm.
This is like an iconic dress. The body is in amazing condition, just beautiful.
It's like finding remnants of the Titanic. You're just so happy to still have a piece of that past.
I want to have one more surprise for the last thing. This is not for sale.
Wow, that's exciting. The piece is apparently so valuable, we have to wear museum gloves to handle it.
This was a glove that Bill Whitton designed for Michael Jackson. So this is a rare couture glove.
Uh-huh.
And this one is between $100,000 to
$200,000. What?
Some of them have went for like $225,000,
$250,000.
So,
oh.
No,
it's so is this actually was used
yes.
by Michael
yeah,
Jackson?
Yeah, this is an old glove.
And you have it all documented?
Yes. Yeah, we made them.
Wow.
Yeah.
Oh.
Better work on this.
My God.
Yeah.
Sarah, are you seeing this?
Whoa.
This is it.
Yeah. It takes about 1,400 stones. It takes about 10 days to make one of these.
Wow. Incredible.
One by one they put on.
I can't believe that I'm actually holding Michael Jackson's gloves.
Isn't it beautiful?
It's
this
incredible.
Is a rare piece. There were different gloves he had. Like this was a couture glove because of the work on it, the detail.
I can't believe that finally something happened this week that made me squeal. Thank you so much for bringing this here.
You're welcome.
And I don't think until 20 or 30 years people really started to appreciate the impact Michael Jackson had on fashion.
So the package includes this?
All these pieces.
And what's
those.
On the, perfect. So let me go through this.
Okay,
and
I'll
let Sarah give me her opinion on a couple of things.
There's a lot of little moth bites. More than $300 probably in moth repair.
It's a lot of bites. Yeah, it is a lot of bites. The lining is shattered completely. So that's like another $100.
I have all these hidden costs like dry cleaning and repairs.
Well, the only thing I could recover my money from immediately would be this. The jacket and the Adrian.
And so when I look at what someone is selling something for, I have to factor in all the hidden costs.
The silk is rotting.
Mm-hmm.
So do you have any leeway in what you offered me?
I would do that.
Yeah?
Yeah?
Okay.
Because I know that you would do the right thing with this. And I have visitation rights.
You have visitation rights, and I will say yes on buying this collection.
Sounds great. Thank
so,
you.
So, yeah, no, thank you. I appreciate
Once
your
again,
courtesy on working with me on the...
Of course.
Yeah.
They found a good home. These are very special pieces. They've been taken care of.
First thing I noticed when Keith brought this dress in was that typical 1920s dresses are straight, and this has been tailored to contour the waist and to flare out. So I looked at the inside, and lo and behold,
oh yes,
we have this very generous seam.
It's actually been altered.
In order for us to really be successful in selling beautiful things, we really need to have our network of people who are artisans that can bring everything up to snuff.
So we have a whole army of people who...
Yeah.
Who make it happen.
If Tatiana were to take it out this much, it's going to add, you know, just under 2 inches on this side, and then on the other side. So hopefully it'll make it more straight.
It's a true flapper dress.
Yeah.
I love it.
Yeah, in every sense of the word.
Yeah.
I mean, look at where it is on me. I don't think I can get into this.
You really can't have a business in Los Angeles without having a wonderful array of people coming into your store.
Oh, this is absolutely...
I have to admit, I was my favorite cut, too, actually.
This is fantastic.
Award-winning actor Diane Salinger just popped in out of the blue.
This actually looks like Tallulah in a Royal Scandal.
I actually like that.
I'm here. I'm acting in this play called Looped about Tallulah Bankhead.
Tallulah Bankhead is just the best of the classic film era dames. She's a wonderful Southern belle, turned stage actress, turned wild Hollywood partier. Hard smoking, hard loving woman. Love her.
Full of life, darling.
Yeah.
I have this one line of dialogue as Tallulah, and I say, really, darling, the last time a man said that to me, I was standing on a diving board wearing nothing but a string of pearls to prove that I was a natural ash blonde.
Oh, that's what I said. Oh, God, that's so risque. We love when people like Diane come in because they really embody the level of passion that we have.
I want something that really moves so that when I get drunker and drunker and more doped up as the play goes on, I can hoist my leg over the chair, darling, and absolutely not encumbered.
Well, fitting is the first part of success.
Oh, darling, you are so right, so right.
Probably not ripping, it's the second part.
Right here.
The big reveal.
Okay, all right.
Wow. That's like a custom-made dress. As soon as Diane walked out in that dress, I could tell she felt something very special.
Really good.
And I can move.
Yeah, I think that
And I want to be able to show my red petticoat.
I'm stunned. I mean, I know who Tallulah Bankhead is, and to look at you in this dress, I see you're channeling her.
I feel I am.
Seriously.
I am channeling her every day more and more. I think Tallulah led us to here.
I love it. I love it.
It's it.
Finding her the perfect Tallulah dress when you could tell she was already imbued with the spirit of Tallulah anyway, it was just wonderful to see her so happy.
I've been living with her for about a month now, and I feel very close to her. I just get emotional about it because there's nothing like it when you can move over and let this spirit take you. Oh, thank you, dear.
You got me started, too.
Ah, Tallulah. Thank you, sweetheart.
Yeah. It was really touching to see how emotional she got, too. She clearly relates to this woman.
Okay, bye.
Thank you.
See
you soon, I hope.
Yes, we'll call you.
Yeah.
Bye.
Bye. She was so awesome. Yeah, she totally. I said she channeled Tallulah. We found her the right dress. Yeah. Molly, an estate liquidator, called from Chicago. Sarah, did you see this message? Jill told me about it. Sounds amazing. I want to call her before she calls anyone else.
I want you to call her.
This literally could be the biggest estate sale that I've ever been to. Okay, well, let's see what happens.
She's in Chicago?
She's in Chicago, yeah. Mm-hmm. Angelica had taken a call from an estate liquidator, and the message intrigued me.
Hello?
Molly?
Hi.
Hi, it's Doris calling you from The Way We Wore. I got your message about the amazing estate that you're handling.
Sure, absolutely.
Great. It's an estate of a former Halston Dior model. Is that true?
Yes. Huh. It's a four-bedroom house, but the whole entire upstairs is just one big, giant closet. So it's, like, totally gobsmacked. Never have I ever seen a closet like this before. Mm-hmm.
So, as far as you know, no one else has had an opportunity to go through the collection.
You have first right.
Okay.
So you're the first person I'm letting in, so...
I appreciate that. I see a lot of competition in this industry when it comes to estate sales. People literally go at midnight and sign up their name to be able to be the first to go into the estate. So is it possible to email me some images?
Yes.
Well, I can't wait to see the goods.
Okay, great. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Wow, sounds like a good one.
Holy smokes. Wow.
The house was abandoned for 2 years?
That's unbelievable. The proof will be in the visuals. I will know whether or not it's a justifiable trip. My intuitive alarm is going, wow,
it's been a long time since I've heard anyone say gobsmacked. So,
this could be really, really big.
While we waited for Molly to send pictures, I took the beaded flapper dress to be restored.
Hello?
Oh, Sarah, how are you?
Good.
Good to see you.
Nice to see you, too. I know you're busy, so we'll make this quick.
Tatiana is one of what I consider our wizards.
This is what I brought you.
Gorgeous.
The good news is it doesn't need any rebeading work.
My husband, Aaron, both of us came from Ukraine, former Soviet Union, and opened the business in 1994.
There's like probably 3-inch allowance in there. So
okay.
If we can open this so that it can possibly be a slipover.
Slip order. Okay.
Yeah.
Fixing vintage. You have to have inspiration for it. You have to know what you're doing, and you have to be very careful not destroy them more. You have to just love what you're doing. That's all. And one more. We have a Chanel jacket for you.
Oh, yeah. The Chanel jacket that has
Chanel jacket, the worn piping around the cuffs.
Coco would be so proud.
Yes, Coco Chanel has exquisite workmanship on the Emperor jacket.
Oh,
so that jacket can go back home
happily. See you later. Thank you.
All the best to you.
You too.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
See you soon.
So I just got these two texts. I left it with Molly that she was going to send me images of the closets so that I could get a sense of what was in there.
She just sent a photograph of a hat.
A turban?
It's a feather.
This closet looks actually really interesting.
Oh, yeah.
That's Yves Saint
Laurent. Yeah.
Killer.
Woo!
I don't know if you're going to Chicago, but I am.
Capital letters, fabulous. I can't remember the last time I actually got so excited about an estate that I literally stopped what I was doing, booked a ticket, and hightailed it out. I told Sarah, we are going to Chicago.
I'm excited and I'm scared because I can only imagine what this is going to do to the bank. The house is right over there. This looks really good.
Did you buy that lady with the feather hat?
When I saw Molly standing out in the driveway wearing that kooky, kind of spacey hat.
Hi!
And those incredible Chanel glitzy shoes, I totally knew that it was going to be a good experience.
Hi! So nice to meet you!
Sarah,
very excited to be here.
Molly, I can't wait to show you the most fantastic closet I've ever experienced.
I can't wait.
I mean, those images that you sent me
Oh,
my God, and the Yves Saint Laurent gown.
Oh, I love it.
Okay, so, entrez vous. This is the foyer.
Wow.
This is Renee, the beneficiary.
Hi, how are you?
The most important person in the shot.
I'm sorry for your loss.
No. Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
Renee had inherited the estate from her spectacularly beautiful Aunt Graziana, and we really felt her presence there.
Amazing. Do you remember her living in this house when
you were
growing up?
They built this house. They customized this house. Yes.
Walking into the house, I was just like, righteous. This is amazing. Usually I'm really ready to race up, but there's just so much to look at here. The weirder it is to me, the more I'm at home. Let's go up to the magical closet. It was a very eccentric house. I mean, from the mermaid coffee table to the tanning booths all over the house, it was wonderfully weird.
So Noreen's helping me.
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you, Sarah, my manager.
Hi, nice to meet you.
So this is the accessory room?
Yes.
This was her beauty room.
Wow. Yeah.
God, everyone needs a beauty room.
Stacked over there, there's, you know, that machine that right. does your, I call it the twerking.
Yeah.
It's like it
yeah,
teaches yeah. you how to twerk.
Yeah.
Is that her with Elizabeth Taylor?
Yes.
Yes.
She's gorgeous.
She started a model in Poland, and then they souped her up and brought her to L.A.
I haven't found any documentation about who she actually modeled for, but we're believing it was Dior.
We don't know much about Graziana's mysterious modeling career, but her clothing collection is about to give us clues to her glamorous past.
Okay, you wanna?
Please.
Start in.
So, this way is where the closet is?
Nope, it's this way. It's this way.
Okay.
We're entering into the magnificence of the closet.
Everybody should have a closet like this.
So...
Wow.
I'm having trouble concentrating right now.
Yes.
Wow. In this closet, FYI, just
shoes. Okay.
Shoes and boots.
Okay. Oh, my God.
Well, when I first walked in, it was more floor-to-ceiling that you couldn't even, there were no paths. And I looked at a few things, and I was taken aback by some of the labels.
This
cape.
With a train. Look at this.
Uh-huh.
So beautiful. And its belt. I would imagine this is late 70s, early 80s. Rive Gauche is the label that Yves Saint Laurent used for his prêt-à-porter line. I love this piece. It's silk organza. It has its matching belt. It's short in the front, long in the back, timeless. It's something you would buy and wear for the rest of your life as long as you keep your shape.
Hey, I love that so much. It's everything.
It's a cape, actually.
It's a cape.
No label.
Is that just... So...
Dodo!
Oh, dear. You sent an image of that. Mm-hmm. I couldn't tell what it was.
Yes.
I want to know this one.
I know. Me too.
She was a serious shopper. This is a woman who is definitely... is after my heart and was in a financial position in the 70s and 80s that I was not in. So I get to live it now. Ooh, what is that? It looks like a unicorn fantasy.
Holy...
What is it?
Holy Dina Montes.
Oh my God.
Holy...
What is it?
Holy Dina Montes.
Wings.
It's, I think it's a headpiece.
Oh my God.
This woman had a whole life in the history of her fashion. Oh, you look so fantastic in that.
Oh, it's a showpiece.
I like this. It gives her a secret past.
Naughty past.
Oh. Well, if this was the entire costume, then yes.
Right.
The showgirl headpiece, that was just one of those anomalous gifts from heaven. It was probably from the 1950s or 60s, and as soon as I saw it, I just thought, Dita. Oh, 5-year-old Sarah could see me now.
Wow. Oh, my God. Sue Tash coat, Sarah.
I hate coats. They don't go anywhere in L.A. But wow. I'm saying yes. I'm saying yes to coats.
Sue Tash is a surface design technique, and it's a wonderful way to create texture.
Yep.
I love this.
And I love the little poofy sleeves.
And I love the scalloped detail.
It's gorge.
This is going to make a bride really happy.
Definitely a def. As the young kids say, def.
But it's an ultra suede with a raglan sleeve. I mean, how
swell. It's crazy.
Adorbs.
Tuxedo? Floating your boat?
Yes. Yeah.
Great. I feel like Pretty Woman. Check the colors on that.
That's incredible. Even though there's no label, I'm pretty sure this is a French-Italian designer, Laura Cesaro. What I love about it is his mixture of crochet and aluminum chainmail.
Right.
It's just wonderfully hippie and wonderfully chic.
This is amazing, Doris.
Isn't that incredible?
Yeah. I'm taking notes so I can be this woman.
I was just going out to get the paper.
Oh, my God.
I love her!
While Sarah and I were literally salivating over the treasures we were digging up in Chicago, Jell and Shelley Lynn were holding down the fort back in Los Angeles.
How's it going?
How can I help you?
I'm looking for a piece.
Okay. I'm really within the 40s, 50s range.
Cool. What's the occasion?
I have a show.
Oh, great. You're a singer?
I am.
Amazing. Cool. My name's Angelica.
Very nice to meet you.
Okay. So, we have 40s and 50s over here.
Okay.
I'm more comfortable in 70s and 80s. Not so comfortable in 40s and 50s, but it's cool to challenge yourself and see what you can do with direction from your clients.
Mara, are you looking just for a performance piece or everyday stuff?
I specifically want to get a performance piece,
okay.
But I'm never upset at going home with more.
Okay, cool.
My goodness. Such beautiful pieces. I adore how the woman's figure was dressed in the 40s, 50s, because it was tailored exactly to a woman's form. It was so complimentary to a woman's figure. A lot of the pieces I'm attracted to, which are also just true to the time, is that they were conservative. I don't like showing a lot of skin. I guess this is where my personal confidence lies.
I happen to really like 50s as well.
Kindred spirits.
I
love your dress.
Oh, thank you. It's 50s. Can I get a fitting room started for you?
I love that.
Okay, cool.
Thank you.
I pulled a couple things I'm going to put upstairs to show you when we get there.
Okay.
I pulled some wild cards, just in case.
Gotcha.
Cool.
Thank you so much.
No problem.
This would be amazing on stage. I'm going to get in so much trouble.
You know what? It's such a simple idea, but... How
just
wonderful.
So yeah. Stunning.
I mean, I could see some gorgeous young thing rocking it with jeans.
In every era, she was queen.
This estate sale is a dream come true for me. Graziana's collection is a treasure trove of classic designers.
and these names are always in demand in Los Angeles.
Huh?
Halston.
Galanos.
It's a hobble style. It hugs the body, so you have to kind of hobble when you wear it.
Oh. Hey!
If I could do this every day, I would give up eating.
Wow. Look at this. This is Holly's harp.
Oh, sweet 80s.
A Los Angeles designer. Her heyday was in the 70s. She designed for a lot of rock stars, a lot of rock star wives. Very Sunset Strip in the 70s.
That's a Holly's harp, too?
Yeah. This is her 80s vibe.
Wow.
But it's lovely.
It's ethereal.
Yeah, she was amazing. I truly loved her. She died not that long ago, tragically too young.
Well, I love the positive negative of the fabric, too. It's beautiful. We've been here for a little more than 2 hours, and in this one massive closet, Sarah and I think have pulled maybe 3 racks of clothing. We have 2 more rooms to go through with jewelry and sweaters and hats, and it's like, oh my God. So my intuition to come here was,
happy moment.
God, my color, my size.
Your fringe. I'll just leave this.
Wow.
So these are photos of the woman whose house we're in right now and whose wardrobe we are all oohing and aahing and going gaga over. She's even wearing some of the clothes we're picking out.
You can see she has the physique of a model, which she was. That's a classic shot. So happy to find it, to see her in this kind of pose.
You could read this woman's life by the progression of what she wore through the decades.
Are you almost done with the shoes?
Halfway.
Halfway, do you want me to help or should I move on to the hats?
Go ahead and move on to hats, I think.
She had a good head size. Love the color. Now, Phyllis Diller.
Oh, I love it.
Love, love, love.
I set this table up as all Jack McConnell.
Oh my God. Jack McConnell is someone that I always appreciate. I mean, excuse me.
Ugh, you look lovely in it. That is really good on you.
Love. I love this. Look at how amazing this hat is. I mean, the placement of the feathers, it's a work of art. They're always masterfully created.
This is the best hat ever. Dumb outfit.
This is such a tough job.
Okay, so in here we have hats, and in this...
More hats?
More hats, but I kind of saved the best for last. At least in my opinion.
I know exactly what those are.
Best Ben.
Yeah.
The Mad Hatter of Chicago.
It was him and his sister. I think her name was Bessie, and his name was Benjamin.
Yes.
Hence the name Bez Ben. And many museums in the United States collect Bez Ben hats. Look at this. He uses elements, like these are leather leaves, and he creates conversational hats. They could be whimsical. This is obviously a Christmas theme. One of the legends that I've heard about Bez Ben is that he would have these midnight madness sales, and he would stand at the top of the stairs, and he would throw hats down, and it was a feeding frenzy.
And didn't he price the hats at, like,
$5? $5, yeah. His hats retailed for, like, several hundred dollars back in the heyday. You know, you put a hat like this on, and it creates a whole personality, I think.
Oh, my God. It looks so incredible on.
Yeah. He created these fantasy hats, and it gave permission for women to be a little kooky.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey!
I'm ready to try these.
You've had success.
So this really cute singer, Mara Ruby, has made a beeline for some of our 50s dresses that seem made just for her.
Got it?
This is perfect.
Amazing.
You guys have such beautiful pieces. Thank you so much.
No problem. Wow. It fits you perfectly.
It's a little tight.
I mean... doesn't look it. It looks incredible. Hey, Shelly.
Yes.
Come here. You got to see this dress.
I was inspired by you.
Hi, twin.
That's gorgeous.
Isn't it beautiful?
Yes.
Do you think this would work for stage?
No, that when I'm holding the mic, if I'm bending over, raising my arms, I'm a little prohibited in stress.
Okay.
I don't think this is a stage piece.
Okay.
It's fine. Another piece.
Great. Yeah,
still going. Wow.
Gorgeous.
It's incredible.
Yeah.
When you find your decade,
yeah,
it works, definitely.
It fits perfectly.
Like a glove.
I can completely move in it.
Yeah. Wow.
I wonder how sweat shows in this dress. Because I get, yeah, my sets are pretty long.
It looks
so cool.
Crazy.
I love.
Oh, it looks fantastic.
Oh my god, what have you found?
Yeah, look at these. These are all Bez Ben.
This is Bez Ben Town?
Yeah,
Bez Ben Town.
All these are Bez Ben. They definitely would be fun additions to our store stock.
In the 30 plus years that Doris has been doing this, and the 20 plus years that I've been doing this, that this is probably one of the top three scores.
I like big and bold. Oh, that's great. What an odd color combination.
It's like a magic closet that just keeps on giving.
Fantastic.
Wow.
Wow. I don't know how I'm going to leave with just one. I don't know how that's going to be possible.
Mara was such a delight to work with. She is such a warm soul.
Can we see? Come on out.
Gorgeous. Wow. And she knows her silhouette. Everything looked amazing on her.
It's definitely vintage, but it looks so contemporary, too. Like,
yeah.
It's so relevant. Like, it's classic.
Zipper?
The friend zipper is insane.
So cool.
Suggestive.
Yeah, I know.
Suggestive, but
kind of living life on the edge right now.
Awesome.
But, it's Nettie Ronstein.
Oh, I see that.
And she was known for her little black dress. I really love this front zipper. The distance that it travels down and then the lines that this creates is just...
That's beautiful.
And these little darts back here, it's very, very minor, but it almost gives it this look like you already have a waist belt on.
Gorgeous.
It's just something very sexy and confident and bold about this dress. And it has pockets.
Yeah.
I could put my hanky in there. I feel like every time I perform in a new dress, I'm adding... of course, the standing history that the dress already carries.
Absolutely. You're kind of carrying on the legacy of whatever fabulous woman wore before.
Completely.
Yeah, and you're making it your own.
Thank you so much.
Absolutely.
I will take this one.
All right.
Sold.
On hanger, just is a simple black dress, but on her body, knockout. And I think she's going to look incredible staying in it.
Great. Oh, my God.
I mean, I thought we found... the dress with the black one, but what happened? Just pop out?
It's all you guys' fault.
Like, oh my god.
Jeez.
You have like Invisigirdle. That's why everything looks good on you. You don't even need foundations. You are foundations.
I will blame my parents.
God bless your parents.
Yeah, praise them. Jeez, please. This is my favorite dress. To me, this is the most sexy. But this is the epitome of a wiggle dress. I can only do the little.
Right.
I can't take large steps. And during my shows, I do a lot of moments where I go down and the readjusting factor will be real. I'm getting into some serious trouble right now because I want to leave with all three, the green, this one, and the other black dress.
All right, cool. We'll be downstairs.
Thank you so much.
Excited to see what you pick.
Bye.
All right.
Each dress makes me feel very powerful, and ultimately that's why I love the dress this way. It's what works for me, so I don't know which one to perform in. All right.
Decisions, decisions, decisions.
So, we have three right here.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
This is the show dress. I am absolutely certain of it.
All right.
Good choice. This will be the dress.
Let's do it.
Cool. When I get new pieces, I put them on when I get home. And then I put an apron on over it, and I cook something in it.
Oh, my goodness.
I feel like, you know, it's getting your energy of your home and into the dress.
That's beautiful.
No, that really is. Let's hope I don't spill anything crazy on
it. I'm sure I know.
All right.
Bye.
Part of the joy and the sadness of this job is coming into a place like this and not being able to meet the person, because I can only imagine how fantastically kooky she was. I mean, definitely the kind of person that I would relate to. I mean, look at this. These are just beautiful, beautiful pieces that fit so well in the LA market. Every girl
will love this. I mean, everyone that sees this swoons. So I love this piece. I'm an absolute lover of the Halston dresses that are beaded. This one is on organza. It doesn't look like it was ever worn. It comes with its original slip. It's in near perfect condition. It's been hanging for a long time, so the shoulder needs a little bit of work. But it's just classic and beautiful. The color's beautiful. And this is kind of like a caftan, kind of like a cape. But I don't know. I think this just appeals to the drag queen in me. I love it.
Yeah, I see a young starlet.
Mm-hmm.
Someone brave, someone 6 feet tall.
Maybe on the red carpet with a plain black evening gown.
Well, it might be a Florence Welch.
Oh, yeah. In either case, I'm packing it and taking it with me. Always pack it inside out.
Snakeskin boots? I mean, that's kind of a no-brainer right there. Got my red marabou coat. This was a necessity in the 70s. Had to have this. And your rose-colored glasses and your platforms if you wanted really to make the grade. This is who I probably would have been in the mid-70s.
I'm just so distracted.
I know.
Molly.
Yep.
I'm ready to give you a number.
Great, I'm ready to hear one.
And it's one that I'm very comfortable with.
I think we're absolutely 1,000% on the same page. That's more than generous, and this is going to help Renee and Renee's family out greatly.
Wonderful. I'm going to write you a check now, though.
Excellent.
So we have a firm deal. Yeah?
Okay, yes.
So
thank you again!
I spent thousands of dollars acquiring one of the best collections of clothing I have ever seen.
Everyone walked away happy, which is always the best case scenario in an estate situation.
I hope you'll call me for other estates.
I'll blow up your phone. Oh. But only for really good stuff. Only okay. Really good stuff.
Okay. Pretty awesome.
If we were archaeologists, this would be the find of the century.
So I know that there'll be a lot more attractive people walking the streets of Los Angeles.
Including us!
Including you.
Now this
is so chic.
It's so awesome.
So this is
I
a two-piecer.
Love this.
It's a strapless
that
with a jacket.
That's beautiful.
Vintage clothing has such a unique flair that people really get addicted to it.
Oh, geez.
It's uber chic.
It is. It's great.
It's the quality, it's the uniqueness, and it's also the value for your bucks. Here's like a wonderful...
I so wish this fit me.
When I find the perfect marriage of what I've invested in, when it goes on the proper body and the proper personality, I mean, it's just, it's magic. One of my favorite moments is when I see photographs of women wearing clothing they've purchased in my store.
I mean, wow, she looks great.
Wow.
Those eyebrows are totally Tallulah.
So cool.
Another satisfied customer.
Lovely young jazz and blues singer Mara Ruby is another of our satisfied customers. That classic Nettie Rosenstein little black dress set the perfect tone for her recent performance at the Mint. And then there's the moment we all love.
Oh, my goodness.
The shipments come. The dog and pony show. That's when I get to show off all the pieces I bought from a giant spending spree.
So, drum roll, please. Everyone gets hyper excited because it's the chance that I have to really show off everything that I've purchased.
I can't believe that all 14 boxes came at the same time.
No, that's
crazy.
I can't
believe they all came.
Well, after that.
It's dog and pony show.
Jordan Feldman is a good friend of mine. He's a comedian and someone who is a true lover of vintage clothing.
You have no money left, obviously.
Wait till you see what's in here. So I called him in to come and experience the dog and pony show.
Wait, this says best hats. Ooh, are you kidding me? What is this?
That's really cool. Who's Chic on Doris?
We just got the boxes.
Look at this. Dita.
You're the first person
to see.
Who am
I, Dita Von Teese?
Those are all the hair.
Oh,
wow.
My God. Look. look how cool this is. Like,
yes, that's awesome.
Kim Kardashian for her next wedding.
These are the best moments. I love the fact that people get excited about seeing beautiful things.
See, that is giving me Grace Jones. The hood is like super Grace Jones. Look at this.
This is miscellaneous awesomeness.
Super drama. Oh my god.
Hey, down in front,
what
down in front.
In tarnation? Is this a cape? Andre Leon Talley. She's in the house. What is this? What was that noise? Oh my god, I think there's something in there.
No, there's not.
There is an animal in there. No, there is a mouse or a cat.
Oh my god! Just kidding.
Or a possum in there?
You sure it wasn't the sweater that scared you?
Maybe it was the sweater.
He's a guy that doesn't mind throwing on some jewels, throwing on a first shrug, you know, just seeing how, a gown looks on.
Who, me?
So he's a lot of fun to have around.
This is like Mad Max.
Yeah.
Could you imagine Rihanna wearing this?
Yeah.
And she was like, oh, this whole thing, I just had to throw it on. I just got out of the bath where I was tanning. Et puis.
More. I think you have maybe too large of a man neck for this.
You know what? I really don't like you telling me that my neck is fat. I think you need to just try harder, Christina.
Okay, that's awesome.
That is editorial. Slow. This is legitimately the best haul you've ever gotten that I've seen.
Yeah, I think that you've seen, yeah.
You do not see this often.
You know what I love about this estate is that there's conservative chic,
yeah,
and then there's completely off the wall.
Off the wall?
Yeah.
This says unicorn fantasy.
Yeah, she was a bohemian,
this
but...
is legit the chicest thing I've ever seen.
Look at with the skirt.
Oh, my God.
Oh,
the best part about it, though...
God, are you joking me?
The Velcro.
What upmarket can you get?
That is...
And then where does it touch again?
Oh, my God. This is not even real. This is not happening.
This is unicorn fantasy, son. I love dog and pony. That's a perk of the job. This is awesome.
Yeah, you look good like that.
You too.
You wait?
Yeah. I always tell customers, it's quality control. You have to go through and, you know, try things on, see how they work.
Hey, walk the catwalk. Come on. Step it.
I love seeing Graziana's amazing collection brought back to life.
Hey, girl.
Oh, that's going to your mama. That's going back to the island.
And I like to think she would enjoy it, too.
Oh, my God.
I love you. This was more than I can handle. I legitimately need to go have a cigarette because I feel like I just had fashion sex.
Oh.
You never blush. Give bad fashion.
Oh.
I guess I'll just take this LA Confidential.
Yeah, you always have to take something.
And just this, just in case. Because it's sunny. Bye, guys.
Bye. Bye, George. Bye, handsome.
Bye.
Quick, lock the door.